Dr. Vinay Thakur.
Hi, good morning.
Who is getting ready for the surgery, and he will be assisted by Dr. Mukti Devkota. Is he Mukti?
Yeah, sure, he is. Just one.
So we know that it is a patient who had neoadjuvant chemotherapy, and now you are taking this patient for neoadjuvant. I understand you are doing surgery defined for your three diseases or three approaches.
Yes.
Can you just elaborate on the asset approach?
Dr. Mohan, first of all, thank you very much for coming to us. It's a very nice pleasure for us to invite you all in this conference under where we will be going to perform the live demonstration of esophagectomy. We have got a good team. You can see our Dr. Sudhir Shrestha. He is our anesthesiologist. And he made the patient very comfortable now. And he is Dr. Mukti Devkota. Yeah, he is surgeon. And he will be assisting, we will be together. And this is Dr. Deepa Vasthi. She will be a camera person for us. And the nurse is here, Upasana Nivaritam. She is our nurse. And we have several staff here also. He is the in charge, and everybody is here. So thank you very much. Regarding this patient, it has been already mentioned. The patient has been put in the lateral position. They will tilted the bed completely. So that we made the position semi-prone. Actually, this is not the prone position totally, we operate on the semi-prone position. The patient was actually in the lateral position, then we tilted the bed, so like this will be about 45 degree angle from the horizontal line. So this is the scapula, tip of the scapula, you can see. This line is the marking of the maximum dorsal muscle. So I will put the three ports, we have got a three port technique. First port will be the camera port that we are going to put in the 7th intercostal muscle. This is approximately roughly corresponds to the tip of the scapula. So this is the 7th intercostal muscle. This will be the tenoimum optical port. So first of all, let's put the tenoimum optical port. Thereafter, we will put the 2-5-imum optical port. One will be the 5th intercostal space, another will be the 9th intercostal space. So we have done this surgery, we will do without the double number, without the single number condition. I have put the condenser intertracheal tube. So both the lungs are ventilated. And we will create the CO2 pneumothorax in order to make the lung collapse. So we don't require the double lumen tube as such for that we do for the other pulmonary surgery. So now we will start night vision. So you can see this is the tip of the scapula. And this corresponds to generally the 7th intercostal space. So we make an incision over here. So we take the clinic length just to make a. We have entered inside the thoracic cavity. Now this is the conventional safety trocar that we use during the laparoscopic, during the abdominal procedure. This is the safety trocar, everybody must be knowing that. So I take this safety trocar, insert inside the chest cavity. That's all. Now this should be inside the chest cavity. So now what we do, we take the CO2 gas, this is the CO2, conventional CO2 pneumothorax will create. So we join to the port, we will keep the pressure about 7 to 8 mm of mercury. Gas flow. So the pressure will be at the intermediate level and the flow rate will be also intermediate, not more than 8 to 10 liter per minute. So this is not like 14 mm energy. We'll be introducing the camera inside. So you can see the lung is collapsed. We have put the three trocars. This is what this is the 10 mm port, which we will be using as an optical port. And these two are the 2-5 mm ports. So this is the 5th intercostal space. This is the 7th intercostal space. This is the 9th intercostal space. These all will be approximately in the mid or posterior axillary line. So we have put this. So now you can see, here. So this is in the prone position. This is the lung. This grasper pressing. This is the upper lobe of the lung. Okay, so this is the fissure you can see. This is the major fissure, this is the lower lobe of the lung. This is the vertebral body you can see here. So these are the intercostal vessels you can see very well. So this is the esophagus, this one. Can you see? Hello? Yeah, this is the esophagus. These are the lymph nodes you can see. This is the white structure, is the vagus nerve, this one. If you move upwards, this is the azygous vein. You can see this is the azygous vein. This is the azygous arch. This is the azygous arch. So this will be draining into the superior vena cava. So this is the superior vena cava. Can you show us this?
Sir, can you explain a little bit of anatomy of azygous vein to our audience?
Yes. So you can see this is the azygous vein, this one. This is the azygous vein, right? So it goes basically in front of the vertebral body. This is located, this is the esophagus, this is the aorta here. So this is located here, beneath the scleroid, beneath the scleroid, this is the beneath the scleroid. So this strains all the structures, get strains from the beneath scleroid organs. So this goes here, and this is the, and also intercostal vein strain here also. You can see the intercostal vessels, this one, this is the intercostal vessels. And this is the azygous vein that turns around at the level of T4. T4 vertebra, and this will go to the superior vena cava. This is the superior vena cava. You can see the superior vena cava. So this is the trend.
Audience here. Yeah. The superior can approach both from the left chest as well as the right chest.
Yes.
So if you approach from the left side, yeah, the problem is that after there is a process like
yes.
It is very difficult to get on top of the So we did approach the vertebrae from the right side of the chest and the left side of the chest. So we can see the entire length of the vertebrae. And a azygous vein is the vein which drains the low part of the body, runs down the chest wall, and then comes and joins the superior vein.
Yeah, so we have put the inserted two gus piece there. The small gus piece that is just to increase the bleeding occurs, then we can soak them. So this is the first one, we start with the 85 that is bisection.